do I carbidize my locks? The answer to that question is yes, I do, and that's today's topic, carbidizing the lock bar. As we continually to flip the knife, there is some mechanical wear that could occur between the locking bar and the back of the blade. And so this is why we carbidize the locking bar. Carbidizing the locking face helps the longevity of the knife and helps it to wear longer, because what we're dealing with here is two different hardnesses. The locking bar itself is in the 30s, maybe 35. The blade steel, I heat treat to 62. And so you constantly have some mechanical wear that's occurring between the locking bar and the blade. So welcome to the back of my bandsaw. This is the back of my bandsaw. This is where I keep my Rockwell hardness tester permanently set up, also my arbor press. What we're gonna do now is we're gonna test this blade. This is a Carpenter's XHP blade that I've heat treated. We're going to test it. This should be about 60 on the Rockwell hardness. Initially, when you quench it, it goes 63, 64. And then after you temper it, the toughness returns to the metal. It gets very odd. And so you have to temper it to bring the toughness back so it doesn't shatter if you drop it. And after the second tempering, it usually ends up at about 60, 61. So what we have here is, this blade is actually 61.5. So that blade is incredibly hard, even after the second tempering. It's a very hard steel. It's actually a stainless tool steel. It's like D2 with chromium in it. And so what you have is, you have a very hard blade steel and then a very soft titanium liner. So the titanium should be about 33, 34 on the Rockwell hardness. You're supposed to trade out your diamond tip for a round ball nose when you're testing the softer material like titanium. I'm not going to do that just because I'm in a little bit of a hurry. The main thing we're trying to show is why we carbidize the lock and what we're trying to achieve. That should be about 10 seconds. And what we have, as this one is 35.5. So the titanium is very much softer than your blade steel. So the locking bar is, this is an all titanium frame lock. The blades I do Moen heat treat, they test out at about 60. And so you have this constant mechanical wear from the flipping of the knife. I build my knives to last a lifetime, and so I do, in fact, carbidize my lock. Carbidizing the lock increases the life of it. You're actually micro-welding a layer of tungsten carbide on the locking face of the titanium locking bar, and that increases the Rockwell hardness to 72. What this does is allows the knife to have a longer lifespan and increase the life of the knife. Here's my carbidizer. You can purchase these. They're manufactured by the bebe manufacturing company in Florida, and there's the telephone number. And basically what this thing is like a Dremel with a piece of carbide, tungsten carbide, stuck in it. Originally my father made me one of these, and I used an actual Dremel tool and my Variac for my anodizer. And I'm not going to go into the how you do that because of liabilities, but it works just as well. Another company you could look into would be the Rocklinizer. Those are a little bit more expensive. They're a few thousand dollars. So what we're getting ready to do, this is the locking face. This is the locking bar. This is the portion of the that locks up against the back of the blade tank. What we're getting ready to do is we're going to
micro weld tungsten carbide onto the surface of this locking face. This is a known technique that a lot of makers use.
This is done very commonly by custom knife makers. It's not done by the production companies so much because it's very time consuming. It's not practical in a production environment. It's too time consuming, it's skill intensive, and so that the production companies typically do, they just drop in an insert and then bolt it in because they don't have the time in a production environment. It's not very practical. But as a custom knife maker, taking the time individually each knife, it's a very known technique amongst the makers. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to clean that face with acetone. Another thing you should take note of, you want to do all this before you set the detent ball. I don't know if you can notice it, but there's a 59 thousandths hole right here in the liner. That's where the detent ball goes. You want to carbidize this lock. You want to carbidize this lock face before you set the detent ball so that it doesn't fall out. Using a propane torch. So all we're wanting to do is just get this locking face cherry red, and then we're going to quench it. All I'm going to use is water for the quench. And now we're going to carbidize this locking face right here using the carbidizer. We're going to micro weld a layer of tungsten carbide onto the locking face. So what this does, this has micro welded a layer of tungsten carbide on top of the layer of titanium that we have work hardened. And so now this lock bar is amazingly hard. It's 72C on the Rockwell hardness. Now I don't have any way of testing that, but I do know that this will not, the blade will no longer wear out this locking bar. This locking bar will actually put wear and tear on the blade. But by the design of the blade, as this knife ages, the lock will only seat itself deeper because we have our geometries correct. And I'll shoot a video on that sometime in the future. But what we've done is we've made this locking bar highly wear resistant for the mechanical wear and increased the duration and have greatly increased the lifespan of the knife.
It's just a way of preventing and taking care of mechanical wear from the locking bar face constantly meeting the blade there. I flip this knife every day for probably 3 years. I haven't had any issues. So the inserts is one way to fix them. You can put an insert in here. But if you carbidize the locking face, it's totally not necessary to have an insert. At least I haven't had any issues. It helps protect the knife and will ensure that the knife will last for years, years and years.
So I was thinking about going to this show. I picked this up while I was in Tennessee at the Spirit of Steel Knife Show. That's a great show. That's Bruce Vole's show. He's an auctioneer. A lot of you guys know him. Used to own a magazine. This is the Mason-Dixon Knife Show. I don't know anything about the show other than it's in Maryland. If anybody has any feedback, I was thinking about checking it out. Please let me know in the comments.
And you can email me, christopher@gillianknives.com. Feel free to reach out. I'll be glad to hear from you. Thanks for watching all the way through. You must like my knife making. If you do, please subscribe. I try to put out content on Wednesdays. Thanks for watching.